Good morning and welcome to Let's Go Parking, the monthly program presented to you by the Berks County Parks and Recreation Department. We're happy you're here with us today. My name is Cathy Wegener. I'm the Recreation and Cultural Programs Manager for the department. And with me are our co-hosts, and they're always here, fellow co-workers. Let them introduce themselves to you. Go ahead.
I'm Becky Hughes, and I'm the Cultural Program Supervisor for the Parks Department.
And I'm Becky Richards. I'm the Recreation Program Supervisor. So it's a Becky and Becky team yet again. Mm-hmm. With Cathy.
It's the Beckys. I should have sat in the middle so I could have had Beckys on either side, like chickens. Anyway, we're here live with you on Tuesday, January the 17th. If you'd like to call us, we'd be happy to have any home viewers that might be watching us this morning. We know most of you seem to catch us later on. But if you are watching this morning, please give us a call here at 610-378-0426. Or after the program, or if you're watching at a different time and you have questions, you can call us at the Heritage Center office, 610-374-8839. We'd be happy to answer your questions or direct you to one of the other Beckys or one of the other offices, depending what the need is. So it's been kind of not that crazy of a winter so far. This week is really gloomy outside, but we still encourage you. We all want you to get outside. There's lots of things to do in the parks at this time of the year. It's a great time to walk on the trails, get out there without all the leaves on the trees. You can see a lot more birds, sometimes the eagle along the Tulpehockin Creek. For sure, our friends, the great blue herons, are there. And they stand out really nicely at this time of year. So it's still a great time to get outside and walk and hike. We've got some bicyclers and runners, of course, and we're hoping for that snow so you can do some sledding or cross-country skiing or snowshoeing, because Becky's going to talk about some of that coming up with some programs that we're doing. So I know, Becky, maybe we were going to go to Becky number one on the end, and maybe just recap a little bit about some of the things that have been happening in the past.
Sure.
If you want to fill us in on the nature program, I mean, or the photography program, or
yep.
the anything
and
about
other
holiday
things.
Lights.
Yeah. Well, and as we just finished up our holiday lights program at Grings Mill during the month of December. So as we already thinking to next December, one of our main projects we would like to do is some major renovations to our model train display. So we are still growing our group of volunteers who like to play with trains. So if you are interested in that, please contact our office. Our information will be at the end of the program. You can contact us. We'd be happy to have you come out. We're hoping to have a volunteer meeting the beginning of March. So you can come out and join us then and learn a little bit maybe more about that project and ways that you can help, even in, you know, when it's kind of cold and gloomy days, you don't want to be in that building, but there are things that you can do to either take to one of our offices to work on, you know, or even take home to work on. And then there are some display things we want to do when the weather gets nicer. So we have some big plans to get that ready for this year. We also started out the year with a first day hike, and we had, Becky was with me. Mm-hmm. It was a great group of people. We had well over 35 people there that day. And, you know, as we were kind of like back and forth with the temperature, mm-hmm. And as it's warming up, I know that people like to get out more. So when it's really cold and frigid, maybe you don't feel as attuned to getting out on the trails, although we're open year round and, you know, all day through, right now we're 8 to 5. As it gets, you know, it's not so terrible out. It's, you know, our trails are still open to get out and get that hike in. This past weekend, we also did a winter nature photography program with Valerie Hoffman, and that was really popular. We will do one in the summertime too, but we don't have a date set yet. But what was different about her program this time of year is that she had a lot of tips to help you to help your equipment to be ready to take photos in any kind of weather. Using things like hand warmers and those silica packets that we get in our shoes and purses, mm-hmm. and save those because they can be used for many other things. And then different features on your camera are to go out there and get the balance just right. And I did want to share, since we were talking about wildlife in the park, We had photographers all over the place. It was great to see. You know, once we actually got out to the park, everybody kind of dispersed and were, you know, over to the island and down the trail. And one lady saw our mink in the park at Grings Mill. Kind of elusive, but there are mink in our park, one or two. So you don't see him very often, and I wish I would have seen that.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him in a while.
Nice.
So
nice.
That, very cool.
Very
cool. I thought I'd share, because that was really neat. And Valerie Hoffman does a great job, so if you're interested, keep in touch with us, and we can let you know when that program is coming up in the summertime.
Great.
So good stuff.
Good.
Well, we do have a couple of, we have a whole pamphlet of programs for the winter months through April here. But we have a couple of things coming up here at the end of January still. There will be a winter tree ID program at 1 o'clock at the Binghamton Nature Center. Be the first program that's being held there at the newly renovated Nature Center at the Antietam Lake Park. If you're interested about that, you should contact us to register for the program. It's geared for adults. But Becky has another program that day as well.
I do. So hopefully, if we do get snow, we plan to do a beginner snowshoe and cross-country skiing program at the Berks County Heritage Center, because our field there at the Heritage Center is a great spot to get out there and just try it. It's nice and flat. It's open. Great place to get your feet under and figure out the right way to snowshoe, although snowshoeing's easy. If you can walk, you can snowshoe. It's more cross-country skiing, getting that gliding going, and there's even a little bit of hills that you can try if you wanted to, but of course we need snow. So our plan is, this is for Saturday, January 28th from 1 to 3 at the Heritage Center. Our plan is, if we don't have snow, we still plan to have the program and demonstrate snowshoes and skis. Probably won't be able to go out and try them, but we still plan to go out for a hike. So maybe enjoy, hopefully, a nice day. But if we have even like 5 inches, we can do the program. But I don't know. We haven't had any yet.
Yeah.
Nothing that's lasted, you know, more than a couple days. So we'll see. But that is also to pre-register. So contact me at 610-374-2944, extension 2611, if you would like to register for that program. And just in case, you know, since I'm throwing it out there, if we ever would get snow, I don't know, Noldy Forest has snowshoes that you can borrow during the week and use at their park. So, you know, if you're home during the day and we get snow, you can actually go and borrow those for free. If you've never done it before, you would need to watch a short video to learn how to snowshoe, and you might need to leave like some kind of a photo ID or something, since you're borrowing their snowshoes. And you can walk around the trails at Noldy Forest on snowshoes for free.
That's great.
Of course, we need snow.
Yeah,
so.
We still need snow. Either way.
It's just a nice thing that's offered by our local state park.
Yeah, that's great.
That's great.
Good, good. Well, jumping to the other Becky, Becky number one, Becky number two. Becky has been running a series of sewing circle programs at the Heritage Center. They're every month, usually the second Saturday.
Usually the second Saturday.
Usually the second Saturday. Sometimes it shifts around depending if there's something else going on. But you just had one here this past weekend, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you talked about the history of sewing machines.
We did.
So why don't you talk about that a little bit?
Well, each month when we do our sewing circle, we have a different program or topic. So the topic last month, or last Saturday, was the history of sewing machines. So we talked about how sewing machines were first invented in 1755.
Huh.
And that, then the Singer sewing machines were around. They were the later ones that were still around in the 1900s.
So what? So were the first sewing machines be even before the treadle kind of ones? You know, I have one of those at home. My grandmother used it always, but
But the first sewing machines, a lot of them didn't have patents, so they didn't progress very far.
Oh, so that's why everybody had a Singer at one point.
Everybody had a Singer because Singer and Howe were the two that were later on.
Yeah,
And they were competitors against each other.
Well, that's interesting. Well, and you said, so you talked about the history of sewing machines, but you also had some new people join this past weekend.
We had some new people. We encourage people to come and bring their sewing projects. A lady brought in part of a quilt, the top of a quilt, that she wanted to know how she could get it quilted. So we encourage people to bring in things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have enough ladies there that know all sorts of different things.
All sorts of things. And if you're going to be working on something, it's more fun to sit and work with others and talk. Sometimes it makes it go a little faster. Not that some of that it's nice to do needlework or knitting or whatever at home by yourself, but I think it's nice to develop a group of friends around the sewing circle. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So next month's topic is how to make drawstring bags. So we're going to bring out the sewing machine, or you can do it by hand, but we're just going to make little small drawstring bags.
Do we need some at the park for stuff?
We can make some.
I think that we should make some for our stuff.
Great.
So if people are interested, they can always call us, find out about when the next sewing circle is or what the topic is, and ask for Becky, and she can tell you all about it. But we do this every month, all year. On a Saturday. What Saturday afternoon? Or Saturday mornings, right?
Saturday mornings.
10 to 12. So you can join us there. Okay. Good. Well, just in case you're tuning in now, we're kind of midway through our program. You're watching Let's Go Parking. We're talking about programs that the Berks County Parks and Recreation Department presents to you. And we'd sure love to have you give us a call now or give us a call later. Again, our office, the one number is 610-374-8839. And we'd be happy to direct you to wherever you need to go. We've got a maple sugar program coming up at the end of February and March, right? We have two of them.
We do, but before that, we also have some full moon programs in February.
Oh, sure. We should jump back. We should jump back.
There's two different ones the same day, so you can kind of choose, you know, which one, and they're a little different. I'm doing one at Shiloh Hills Park in Spring Township. We tried to do it last year, and believe it or not, we had to cancel for snow. That was the weekend we had all that snow, and nobody was getting anywhere. So we're trying it again, and again, hoping for snow, but we're just going to, you know, again, learning how to snowshoe. If you prefer to ski, you could bring those along. That'll be from 6 to 8 at the Shiloh Hills Park. They have a variety of trails that kind of go through wooded area around the parking lot and over near the school. This is near Shiloh Hills Elementary. So that should be a fun program. Again, we would like you to pre-register with me at 610-374-2944 extension 2611. This is co-sponsored with Spring Township. We do have snowshoes that you can borrow, you know, or if you'd like to ski or to rent your own equipment, we can guide you in where to go for that. But because it's a full moon, you know, we can't just do one program. We've got two great programs. Same night, you know, getting out there and enjoying that full moon. Jennifer has a great program up at the Angora Fruit Farm the same night, February 11th from 6 to 8, called the Full Moon and Lunar Eclipse Celebration and Hike. So she's going to have you come out and learn some information, you know, the first full moon and the lunar eclipse of this year, and learning the science behind that. With her and her staff, and of course they'll have a campfire you can warm up next to, and with some hot chocolate and some marshmallows. That will be a $5 per family registration, and again she would like pre-registration directly to their office. Yep. And that's all ages, but that sounds like a lot of fun.
All fun. So there's a bunch of things coming up to get you outside here over the winter.
Yes. But then Jennifer and I had also kind of had the same idea and put this in motion to offer the first maple sugaring programs in Berks County. I'm very excited about that. We have a volunteer with our Parks Department who does maple sugaring programs, and we've identified some trees in our parks up at the Angora Fruit Farm and also at our Grings Mill Recreation Area, where we'll just be able to do a demonstration on how you would tap a tree to get out the sap, and then how you boil it down to get maple syrup. So it should be a great demonstration program. You would need to register for both, for one or the other. The first program is Saturday, February 25th from 1 to 3, and that's at our Grings Mill Recreation Area. We'll be meeting in the barn and then walking out to our grove of trees. And then the other program is Saturday, March 4th. So we have alternating Saturdays, March 4th from 1 to 3 up at our Angora Fruit Farm. Should be a great program. It's $3 per person. We do need you to pre-register as spaces, you know, we expect it to fill up, so spaces could be limited. We were certainly really excited about these programs, so yeah. Something very different.
Yeah.
And we even hope to even have a kind of a tasting, so you can taste the difference between what you buy in the store to what real maple syrup is, you know, and there's a real big difference. So really excited about that, and to work with our Parks volunteer who's been doing these programs for many years and brings out all his own stuff. We're really excited.
Yeah, I think it's going to be great. So we hope that, you know, we hope not for a big snowfall at the end of February. So, but between now and then, we need some for some of these other outdoor snowshoeing and cross-country skiing programs.
Right.
Well, one other thing that's happening in February, we're going to kick off our volunteer training recruiting season a little earlier. So we have a meeting, coming up on Saturday, February the 4th, right, Becky?
Right. So it'll be on February the 4th, and it's going to be our first session to be able to train tour guides.
Right.
We are looking for tour guides.
We are looking for tour guides. And that's going to be from at 1 o'clock?
At 1 o'clock.
At the Heritage Center. We're going to meet at the Stone Farmhouse, our office there, Saturday, February 4th, for our kickoff meeting, and to talk to people who would like to be tour guides for the Gruber Wagon Works and Heaster Canal Center, and just the site in general, and just to start our training season for that, and you know, just try to get people to meet others, to meet other guides that are already with us, and to go forward from there. I know we have some photographs that we thought we might run through and let Becky talk about our volunteer program, about all the opportunities that they have.
So we look for volunteers to do lots of different things. I think these ladies are standing at our information table at one of our festivals or events and things like that. So we also, we do mural painting at our fiddle festival, so there's some ladies painting different things. And then a lot of the ladies come out and volunteer to do our arts and crafts. So we do all sorts of different arts and crafts depending on what the event is.
Right. And while these photos are showing a lot of artsy, craftsy kind of things, that is a major, they do help with a lot of those hands-on activities at all of our events. You know, Kite Day comes up, and Egg Extravaganza are one of the
weird
first.
Science.
That this, some of our volunteers share their expertise in science, or if they're basket weavers, or if they're anything that they might have a knowledge of that they can share with us, with the kids.
They do. That's a picture of every year we clean, and we clean our Wagon Works and Canal Center and ready for the season. So it's a picture of one of our volunteers vacuuming the floor.
So not only do we have craft programs and tour guides and working at an information desk, but you know, just general maintenance of our buildings and the site. Cleaning is a big thing every spring and fall during the summer too. But things like that are needed. So like, you may not want to be a tour guide, or you may not want to work in the country store, but maybe you could help us fix some things, or maybe you could help us vacuum, or maybe you could help us do some of the school programs that we do, the traveling trunk. We have volunteers that join us for those things. So again, if you have a love of history, if you like talking to people, you like meeting people from different places, this is a great opportunity. We have a, you know, great family of volunteers that sit on the porch with us or come out when we have special programs and help us. But tour guide meeting, we're really hoping that we'll get some interested people, even if you just want to come and ask questions. That's Saturday, February the 4th from 1 o'clock. It might only be like an hour and a half. We won't keep you as long as you want to be there. And we hope that that will kick things off. And then Becky has a whole series of programs planned throughout the
the months, February, March, April, until we open and actually kick more things off. One other program that I did want to throw out there to you as well is all our fly tying class that we do in cooperation with the Berks County Fly Tiers. That's going to kick off on Tuesday, March the 7th. It runs every Tuesday night through April the 11th. So there are six classes. It costs $30, which also includes a year of membership in the Berks Fly Tiers Club. So the guys are really talented and skilled and really enjoy sharing their knowledge and information. And we are real happy to work cooperatively with them to share the joy of fly fishing. So it's a chance for you to tie a bunch of flies that you might not get to do otherwise and learn about fly fishing in general. So again, we ask that you can call us at 610-374-8839 to ask more questions about that program. But Jack Tucker and Rich Chappelle are the coordinators of the event, and we just kind of host it, provide plugs for electric lights and tables. So if you're interested in fly tying, this is a great program to get out and try. So that is coming up in March as well, and we have a lot of other things that are happening later on. We are going to continue our Pennsylvania German language class. We're going to start that in April after the fly tire class ends. So that was really popular last year, so if you're interested in learning Pennsylvania German, you can let us know, give us a call. It's an eight-week course with Keith Brinsenhoff, and they had a lot of fun. My favorite part was the very last class. We went to eat at the Deutsche Eck restaurant. That was the best part of the whole program.
I'm thinking I want to do it.
You want to do it this year.
It was good.
It was good. I think people learned a little bit of the language. You got to use it to remember it, but it was a lot of fun. So, anyway, do you guys have anything else you want to recap that's coming up before we have to go? They're flashing signs at me.
No.
Did we cover everything?
Oh my gosh.
Need some snow. We need some snow for coming up here. The next thing we've got coming up is the beginner snowshoe and cross-country skiing class. We want enough snow, but not too much, because that's also the tree ID day. It's kind of a combination of what we need, and we would like you to get out on February 11th to view the lunar eclipse and hike up at the Angora Free Farm, or go on a moonlight hike with us at Shiloh Hills and the Spring Township Parks and Recreation Department. One other thing that's coming up that I did not mention, at the end of February, there's a owl prowl on Saturday, February 25th at 5:30. Again, this program will be held at the newly opened Binghamton Nature Center on Hill Road, and there is a registration required for that program. It's a good program for families with children, and you would register with Jennifer at the Nature Center or at the fruit farm. So again, if you're interested in that, you'll see our number here coming up shortly at the end of the program, and just give us a call and we'll direct you to there. So, what do you guys, anything else?
It's very busy winter.
Yeah. A lot of people think things don't happen in the park in the winter time, but we're there working hard. So they're telling us it's time to end the program. So from me and the Becky duo next to me, we say goodbye, and we hope to see you out in the park. And until next month, let's go parking. Have a great day.